Hello, welcome to my Artus Logics videos. My today's topic is commercial off-the-shelf real-time operating systems. What is COTS real-time operating system all about? They are nothing but the readily available RTOSes in the market which can be used as is in your embedded applications. Some examples of such commercially available real-time operating systems are VxWorks, which is the product of Wind River Systems, QNX, MicroCOS, Integrity, etc. So let us talk about if you want to buy and use a commercially available real-time operating system for your embedded application, then what are the different criteria, different aspects you should be looking at before you make a right decision, right? So let's see what are some of the important and critical features or must-haves or fundamental requirements an RTOS should have. First one, an RTOS should provide easily understandable application programming interface, that is APIs. For example, an API to create a task or a thread, an API to delete a task, an API to set or change the priority of a task during runtime in your embedded application, and APIs to create and manage semaphores, mutex, and create and manage message queues for various purposes in your embedded application. Apart from these basic APIs, an RTOS should also provide a wide range of APIs to provide your application tasks with information about the system. For example, stack information, memory information, information on kernel objects. So this system information is very important for the purpose of debugging or analyzing your application in case of failures. Yeah. Then second thing is, does the RTOS support priority-based preemptive multitasking? And along with priority-based preemptive scheduling, does it also support time-based or round-robin scheduling of tasks in case of the tasks of equal priority in your application? Okay. The next thing is, RTOS kernel you are going to choose is easily scalable, which means that you can easily remove certain functionality or features of the kernel which you don't need for your application, or easily add any feature which your application needs and rebuild the kernel. Okay. Then portability, which means the application with the RTOS should be able to run on different hardware platforms. And that is possible only when a good RTOS abstracts or separates the hardware details from software through consistent APIs, right? And an RTOS should also provide you with a good and user-friendly integrated development environment where you can develop efficiently your embedded application code, right? Use make files and build and rebuild the application with the RTOS kernel. It should also allow on development environment the ability to scale the features or functionalities of the kernel. Okay. Then an RTOS which guarantees low or minimum interrupt latency. Right? Interrupt latency is usually referred to as the amount of time taken between the time an external interrupt arrives and until the time the interrupt service routine begins the execution. So let's see what adds to latency and how RTOS is responsible in this case. Number one, sometimes an RTOS disables interrupts while it is running a critical section of the code. And during this time, if an interrupt occurs, it has to wait until the critical section is over. So this is referred to as operating system interrupt latency usually. Okay. So then number two, when an interrupt occurs, the context of the currently running task needs to be saved before it switches to the interrupt service routine. Right. So what exactly is the context of a task? I will explain in my other videos. Okay. So apart from these important features, what else you should look for in a commercially available real-time operating system? Let's see. Number one, it should guarantee safety. The RTOS should be deterministic, which offers reliability and predictability of the performance at any given point of time or the scenario. Number two, security. An RTOS must be secure by its design and support cybersecurity for your application, which is very important and critical in today's embedded systems to address safety or security concerns, right? Number three, reliability. And RTOS must always perform as expected, right? By always producing the same outcome, even though there is a variation in the input conditions and the environment around the embedded system, right? And the last one, certification aspect. In applications, in embedded systems where safety is a criteria, you should often get your software certified from different agencies like safety agencies, FAA and RTCA's DO-178 standard in case of avionics, and IEC 62304 for medical systems, right? So how certifiable is the RTOS?